Captain Kirk, I've just beamed up from Vulcan.
Why?
I need help with a virus on Vulcan.
Some doctors have all the luck.
I'd like to speak with Mr. Spock.
There are other Vulcans aboard.
But Spock's half Vulcan and half human, which is unusual.
Yes, I'd say that's rare.
It qualifies him for advice in this delicate matter. Captain, I'll meet you on the bridge after I speak with Mr. Spock. Mr. Spock, forgive me for smiling. I'm just so happy to see you.
Humans smile with so little provocation.
Yes, Mr. Spock, a virus has broken out, and my son is infected. I need some half-Vulcan, half-human blood, and the authorities just won't give it to me. What do I do?
I've lived on Vulcan so long, married a Vulcan, raised a son on Vulcan, without understanding what it means to be a Vulcan.
Well, then you'll help me?
It would seem the only answer.
Thank you, Spock. I'm going to report my appreciation to your captain right away.
If you will excuse me.
A small ship, Captain. It's been there 5 minutes.
Stand by your phasers, Mr. Chao.
Phasers armed and ready, sir.
Captain Kirk, Mr. Spock has been most
Captain,
helpful.
The alien ship has changed course and speed, moving directly toward us at warp 8.
Fletcher's on. Red alert. Phasers stand by to fire on my order.
Aye, sir. Shields on. Phasers manned and ready, sir. Here he comes. Range decreasing. Speed dropping close to sublight.
Hold your fire, Mr. Chekhov.
Laser is locked on target. Range closing. 75,000 kilometers.
Fire.
Got him!
Wow, that was close! Well done!
Secure from general quarters.
Thank you, Captain. I regret the intrusion.
So did they.
Yes, I bet you they did.